Donald Trump's a style icon.
Is he? But is he? All right, you just watched former Trump White House.
I wasn't expecting it to be that short.
Former Trump White House advisor Stephen Miller, who is not a looker himself, does have some thoughts on Donald Trump's fashion sense, I guess. Look, I don't know why this is a thing today. Like, I don't know why this is a thing, but it is happening, and the Biden camp has felt the need to respond to it. Because we live in America and there's nothing important happening. Yeah. There's, you know, no issue that needs to be addressed. We just gotta talk about the fashion sense of these politicians. So he was responding to an equally sociopathic or psychopathic, I should say, New York Times piece titled "Your Biden Guide to Dressing Younger." No, how about no? That's the only accurate and appropriate response.
It's not for me, but I don't hate it as much as you.
I have never noticed Biden's sense of style. Like,
I also have never noticed his sense of style. That's true.
Case closed. So the piece was written by a guy named Guy Trebe, a reporter for the style section of the Times. And well, lots of praise for Biden. I'll give you an example. Joe Biden is a dapper guy. He always has been. Listen, that might be true. I don't know. I never noticed, and I just don't think it's important.
So, that is true. It is certainly not objectively important. It is the style section of the New York Times. So this is, to them, it's important because that's what they do.
Oh, it's such a good point, John. Thank you for being fair.
I try to be.
You're right. This is the style section. This is where this kind of mindless drivel would live.
You are not a fan of the style section. They put in some photos of him where he does look like he's not wearing stuff that he would wear in the 70s and 80s. A lot of people, they lock in and they never learn. So I'll give him minor credit there. But as you said, I've never noticed it consciously. It took an article for me to notice it.
Yeah. And you know what? After reading the piece, I did notice that Biden's good about like well-fitting suits.
He's a tailor.
They are tailored. Yeah. And like, listen, someone should tell Cenk, like, suits should be tailored. They should. Like, the suits are not gonna look good unless you go to the tailor and you do the like pins, and then they do the sewing and they make sure it hugs your body. You want it to hug your body. You wanna look good.
Yeah. Meanwhile, you wanna look good. Cenk under the sewing machine.
But you men don't have to do makeup. You barely have to care about your hair. In the very least, just take a moment to go to the tailor. Just a moment. I'm not asking you to tailor it yourself. I'm asking you to take it to the tailor. Do the right thing. Do it for the American people. Okay, so the basic thesis.
Get off your ass and go to the tailor. That should be every style section of the New York Times. Guys, get off your ass and go to the tailor.
Yes, absolutely. So the basic thesis of this piece is that Joe Biden is a fashion mastermind for knowing how to properly dress as an older man. Yeah. When Donald J. Trump, now 77, derides his 81-year-old opponent for daughtering Uncle Joe, he is missing a point any tailor would be happy to clarify. There is getting old, there is looking old. To avoid having your clothes add unnecessary years, make style your friend.
That was the log line of Style Log back in the day. Make style your friend.
Was it?
No, I don't think so, but
no one knows what Style Log is. Style Log has.
That used to be fun.
Style Log was a show on TYT Network that lasted like a few days, I think.
You put a lot of work into it in those few days.
We did in those few days, yes. Strategizing for the dynamics of an aging body requires, I can't do this anymore. I just can't. Everyone knows that Joe Biden's old. It doesn't matter what he wears. He could wear a potato sack, he could wear a well-fitting tailored suit. He's 81 years old. Mm-hmm. And everyone knows it and everyone's talking about it. Let's not kid ourselves.
That looks okay.
Okay, but the suit is fine. The suit does nothing to make him look younger. Like, let's just, come on.
I think it doesn't deduct points in the way that an ill-fitting suit could. I think having bought suits, there's actually a lot of small, subtle things in suits that can go wrong. This is a top to a suit that was at one point tailored, but it no longer really fits me all that well. And yet at the same time, it's the one that fits me the best. So that's its own unique nightmare.
Looks like it fits you really well.
Oh, well, thank you. Yeah. Thank you. Unfortunately, I periodically in my life will expand in various ways. Some of them good, some of them bad. Neither of them good for the tailoring situation. Mm-hmm. But the issue is that I think Joe Biden is doing I don't want to say the bare minimum because that sounds judgy. Just look presentable.
Right.
Look professional or whatever. A lot of politicians do not meet that. And obviously, as we're going to get to, like regardless of what Stephen Miller screams at Sean Hannity, Trump does not do that bare minimum, which is weird for a guy who has literally sold suits and ties before professionally.
So apparently Stephen Miller wanted to prove that he could be even more shameless in, I guess, licking his preferred candidate's boots. And in this case, of course, it's Donald Trump. And so we showed you that little snippet of Miller earlier. Don't worry, we're gonna give you more context. Let's watch.
Let me also just say, since we're addressing the subject of style, the most stylish president and first lady in our lifetimes are Donald Trump and Melania Trump. Donald Trump's a style icon. He changed American fashion in The Apprentice. People spent the next 10 years trying to dress like Donald Trump. So if anybody deserves a puff piece on their sense of style, it's Donald Trump and the first lady. Joe Biden, to the point that Mike Huckabee made so well, looks like a walking corpse. The only style article that should be written about Joe Biden is how you've mastered the art of looking embalmed.
Why is he yelling?
Yeah.
We're talking about fashion.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know why he's yelling.
I love a couple things visually about that. Obviously, an argument should stand or fall on the merits or whatever. And I think we've laid out some of the merits of how Joe Biden is perfectly fine in terms of fashion and Trump is a train wreck, as we'll show. But visually also, I love that as he's saying that, they put up B-roll of Joe Biden where Joe Biden looks fine. Like it undercuts his point.
Yeah.
And also it's being made by a guy who like screams at the camera and then looks like he could just do this and then recede back into his coffin. You're gonna criticize Joe Biden, Stephen Miller? The sun's coming out, flee, flee.
Okay.
Donald Trump's a style icon.
We gotta keep that sound clip.
He sounds like a leprechaun.
An angry one.
He just sounds angry and I don't know what he's angry about. Like I can't imagine.
Donald Trump's a style icon.
Okay. It's style icon. Okay, so look, I disagree. Like Trump wears the same thing all the time, right? Like
yeah, and it does him no favors.
Okay, so let's adjudicate this appropriately with evidence. So let's take a look at the many outfits of said style icon, Donald Trump. He loves his long ties, which
that is so too long.
Okay, John, listen. I hate to admit that I don't know what the proper tie length is. So what is a proper tie length?
Look, there is some flexibility, okay? Basically, it's supposed to reach your belt. Maybe it's slightly shorter. Generally, you don't want to see shirt underneath it, but it's not supposed to go past your belt. That's ridiculous. And it immediately makes people think, considering all that we know about him, that he's overcompensating for something with that. It's way too long. It looks ridiculous. And you're not always going to get it perfectly right. Mine right now is slightly too short, but you're not going to see it with the desk What?
The tie I got you is too short.
No, I tied it slightly too short today because there's variation or whatever. But there's no variation with Trump. It's always 3 inches too long.
That's right. You can shorten it.
By he can fix that easily, 100%.
So he does that on purpose?
He does it on purpose.
Okay, all right. Trump also wears bow ties, although I don't remember. Yeah, there we go. There's an example of him wearing a bow tie, okay. I have no comment on that.
I can imagine him laying in a coffin at a wake like that, yeah, I think.
And he likes to couple the bow tie with fancy gold sneakers. I'm just kidding. I don't know if he's ever actually worn those shoes. But by the way, the joke is really on people who didn't buy those gold sneakers. Because A, the resale value is insane, but also I would venture to say that years from now it's gonna be worth even more. Those gold
sneakers. Assuming you ever get them. Remember, it was gonna take like weeks and weeks and weeks and weeks to ever get them. We'll see if people do. Maybe they do.
We'll see.
Yeah.
But
So the overall issue with Donald Trump is that for a guy who has literally sold menswear in his life and presents himself as like this big alpha guy or whatever, who has all the money in the world to consult with all of the world's stylists if he wants to, he strikes out almost every single time. It's not just about the ties being too long, nothing he wears is tailored properly. And I think there's a couple different reasons for that. One is that he surrounds himself with yes men, he is too small mentally and emotionally to ever ask anyone for help. He wouldn't ask someone, hey, could this look better? And also, I think there's sort of like a vanity thing to it. So he's obviously a guy that's quite a bit overweight. And the thing you think as a guy is, if I'm overweight, then I'll wear bigger stuff to hide it. But that's not generally how it works, particularly for suits. That just makes you look like kind of If you tailor it, even if you're overweight, it can look better. It can suit a body, even a body that is overweight, better. But he doesn't do that. And also, he always wears like the same suit and the same red tie. So there's no style to it at all. There's no expression of something that he likes. It does nothing for him. It doesn't matter.
Yeah.
This is pointless.
This is pointless. It doesn't matter. But okay, look, I think that we've actually reached an incredibly important conclusion with this incredibly unimportant story, which is you gotta go see a tailor. Like, you just do, right?
You can't.
Seems like that's gonna solve a lot. One other thing I wanna bring up. So let's go to the white tie event attire. Something looks off, but again, I guess I don't care at all about men's fashion because something looks off, but I don't know what it is. Do you know what it is?
I mean, I have never worn anything like that, but his sleeves are too long. I would believe that you're supposed to see like a little bit standing, you're supposed to see a little bit of sleeve beneath the jacket. And then like, so this sitting is the right amount.
Is the jacket supposed to be a crop top?
I know that doesn't look right to me. Okay. I can't speak to that because I've never worn that before. It doesn't look right to me. Melania looks pretty great. I mean, I think she looks very stylish.
Yes, she always looks great.
The slashes on the chest or whatever, that looks a little cheap. But other than that, she looks great. She is stylish, I think.
She is.
Because she cares and I bet she talks to people. But of course, Trump doesn't do that.
She was a fashion model.
100%, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, that's.
Yeah, no criticism.
She has an obligation to the American people to always look great. Like, you were a fashion model. And she does. She always does look great, in my opinion.
Yeah.
So, anyway, and then. Oh, yeah, one more. Last but not least, humble producer's personal favorite outfit. So, here we go. Let's go to the last photo of Trump. A little cash. He's got the sports coat, but he's still cash.
That can't be
real. Is that
real?
That's not real.
That can't be real. No. That cannot be real.
Yeah, I don't know.
The white shoe, well, I mean, maybe like he played golf and then he threw a jacket on over it or something.
Maybe.
But the pants are, they're wrinkled as hell. They're way too big. It's just, the whole thing is just a mess.
Thanks for watching. If you become a member, you get to watch all this ad-free, except for, of course, this ad. Still, hit the join button below.